people. I'm Ruchi.
And I'm Deepak.
Today at Canadian Parinde, we're soon gonna talk about the expenses that comes with a house, and nobody talk about them. Anybody we talk to these days, either they talk about making a plan for summer or about buying the house. Either way,
two activities.
Either way, they might have bought the house or actually they are in the planning to start looking for the house. Everyone do talk about how much it actually costs them to buy the house, what's a mortgage they will be gonna pay, but nobody a single person talk about the actual expenses that comes with the house. No realtor, no mortgage agent, not even your best friends.
Yeah, so here's the thing. These expenses actually screwed up our budget. It's gonna screw up your budget too, not just the monthly, gonna yearly. But one person who's gonna talk about it, actually two people who always gonna talk about and bring out the real facts is
Ruchi and Deepak. We'll be back right after this music. You don't go anywhere.
So we came into our house, we were very happy, parked our car, and we wanted to get into the house through the garage. We came in and we were like opening the garage and it was not opening, right? And we were like, why this thing is not opening? And then we realized that there is no garage opener. So we installed the garage opener. We bought the one Chamberlain one from the Home Depot. It was around $400. And on top of that, it costs us $100 to get this installed. This guy.
Now that's about the exterior. Let's go inside. I'm super excited to show you the inside of the house. Now, when we entered into the house and saw the kitchen, I was not very happy looking at the kitchen, what I was assuming it to be. And the only reason is, it doesn't have the appliances, it doesn't have a backsplash really. But we are happy because we already have booked our appliances quite ahead in time and got ourselves the best deal.
Well, even with the deal, it is a lot of money to spend on. I mean, a refrigerator, a gas oven, and a dishwasher costs us around $5,500.
On top, washer and dryer.
That's another $2,000.
Actually, we still have a comprehensive list of what brand we chose for the appliances, what features we actually look for, which store we went to get the best deal. So if you want to know such detail, let us know in comments below. We'll be happy to share that in another video. So getting the appliances is one deal, but getting them installed is whole of a different story. It's really hard to get a good licensed contractor who can actually install your appliances in a reasonable price. I remember we reached out to around 4 contractors and finally we paid $800 to install our appliances. Now with the resale house, you probably don't have to spend on appliances right away, but keep in mind, sooner or later you may want to spend a little bit on appliances depending upon their condition. I think Aisha should show that. So, a little story behind it. This was a plain wall we got from builder because first, their variety or the options were not something that we wanted to have. Second, they were way too expensive for that outdated style. So what we did, we reached out in the market trying to get quotes and we end up getting a $1,200 quote. Its area is not much, but still the person was charging $1,200 plus our own material. So Deepak and myself, we are a little handy. We took a challenge again and voila, we installed it ourselves.
You guys must be thinking, why are we scaring you guys for buying a house? Why are we telling all these expenses? Well, you know, first of all, we want to make sure that you know about all these expenses, but to the most important, we're gonna tell you how we paid for these expenses without taking the money out from the bank. There are some simple ways that you can use so that these expenses won't hurt your pocket right away. That we're gonna talk about in the end of the video.
Now in your house, you also would like to cover your windows. Now there are two options. Either you can buy curtain and curtain rods or just the blinds. Now installing blinds could be a little expensive, especially if you are hiring a third company. The quote that we got for our house covering all the windows was around 4500, but as we don't wanted to cover all the windows, so we tried to go with a combination of, in some windows we had the blinds installed, and in certain rooms we just have the combination of curtain rods and curtains. Guys, now I'm taking you to the man cove. So anytime when Deepak needs a timeout, he come in the basement. That's his area. So that's an interesting way how we are utilizing our unfinished basement. This is our hangout place, especially when our baby sleeps. So that's the workshop. Not pretty fancy, but this is the station where Deepak has been working from last 1 month, and he built us this awesome fireplace.
So basement is a very complicated part of the house. No one shows you the basements in the house tour because they're generally dirty. People keep things for the storage in the basement. So basement contains all the important machinery that actually runs for your house. So first one is, say, the furnace. This is the unit which actually produces the hot air for your house, especially in this cold weather. It is very important for this unit to be working all the time. If these equipments go down, it can cost you a lot. Say, for example, our friend who recently bought a house 15 years old without any condition. So they didn't get the chance to inspect any of these equipments. And the month they moved in, they realized that there is some problem with their air conditioner as well as furnace. And it cost them around $7,500 to get those units replaced. It's a lot of money. So make sure you keep that money in your account, especially for this purpose.
I made them. They turned out to be so nice. By the way, you don't have to spend on all these expenses right away. Say with us, we spend on the most important things in the first 2 months, and then slowly we roll over to other things. Okay, not that these lights are bad, they're extremely really bad. We really wanted to change these lights fixture as soon as we have entered into the house, but this is expensive. So one weekend we went to Home Depot, got ourselves a few sample of the light that we can actually install on kitchen island or in the living room. And we find, man, these lights are really very expensive. I'll show you. So on an average, you are looking around 100 to 150 for one single pendant light. And don't forget the cost of installing it if you're not handy. For us, my superhero installed them for me.
Chalo ji, hum lag gaye kaam pe. I mean, installing and changing these lights is not difficult. If you haven't done any project by yourself, I would say start with this one. All you need is a couple of tools, and by that you can easily save at least $50 to $100 for changing one light. In my opinion, every man should be able to change a light.
Every woman should also be able to change the light. Well, in our case, I changed the first bulb of my life after getting married to him.
Like every other project, before starting, we always take quotes from at least 2 to 3 different contractors just to see, you know, how much they're gonna charge us versus how much we're gonna save. So for painting the whole house, the contractor was charging around $4,500 just a neutral one color paint. And for something like this, an accent wall, someone was charging us around $1,500. Well, that is another project that you can do by yourself if you want to get little dirty, you want to take up little different project. So one more thing that you will not find in many of the resale homes as well as in the brand new home is a water softener. Having a water softener installed is very important, otherwise that can not only ruin your skin or your damage your hair, but also can damage your furnace, can damage your taps, can damage your appliances. So when we moved in, that's the first thing we did, get our water softener installed, and it cost us another $1,000 for that. We got this question a lot of times, especially when we talk to you guys about whether should we buy a smaller house, an older house with a bigger backyards, or buying a new house with a smaller backyards, but a small in size. A bigger house definitely comes with a lot of care and maintenance. Every season you have to take care, you have to mow the lawn, you have to take care of the grass. On top of that, you will require a bigger deck and a bigger fence to cost. Brand new homes definitely doesn't come with a deck as well as fence, but also resale home doesn't necessarily need to have both things as well.
Now talking about the maintenance of the lawn, usually you have to buy seed, fertilizer and soil for every spring and fall. If you don't want to maintain your lawn by your own, then you are looking at $700 to $1,000 to pay to somebody else for taking care of your lawn. And trust me, nobody actually do that unless you have a lazy butt. But just for your information guys, our backyard doesn't look very pretty, and the reason only is that we just got rid of the snow. Now it's a spring season now, and soon we are expecting to get some green grass, for which we actually put on the seeds last fall. If you are following our Instagram, you know what I'm talking about.
Now to build a deck so that you can enjoy sitting there sipping your beer in a lawn chair, you probably need around $3,500 to $4,000. That's even with a normal pressure treated lumber. Assuming your neighbors will agree, you need to get at least $3,500 to get the fence done on the tree side.
Now if you're looking to buy the resale house, which is like almost 10 to 15 year old, it has whole of a different list that you should be ready for. The very first thing you should pay attention is the condition of the roof. Now it may cost you from $2,000 to $10,000 depending upon the condition of the roof as well as the material used. For example, if it shingles, it may gonna cost you $7,000 for the house built on a 36 lot. And the second thing you have to pay closely attention is the windows. Really old house usually have the inefficient older windows that need to be changed in coming few years. Now having the inefficient windows, it has a disadvantage because it's adding on to your electricity bill. Being said, the house climate control system has to work harder to compensate with any of the leak happening from this windows.
The third one is, as we already talked about, furnace and air conditioning. Houses which are 15 years old and more definitely requires to replace those two equipments as they are very important, and the cost is around $7,500 for those ones.
So let's come back to how we actually paid for all these expenses. Overall, it was around $50,000 that we had to spend over this time. That's what we figured it out. So the first thing we did is, right when we bought our house, we started putting $100 to $200 every month in a separate account for all these repairs. We know that we're gonna have to spend money at least on buying the equipments, at least on buying the appliances. So that really helped us. By the time when we got our house, we had some good money saved there so that we can start putting that money for buying things. Second is, for bigger expenses, like if you have to change your furnace, you have to change your air conditioning, you have to replace your windows, or you have to get your roofing done, all the well-reputed companies offer 0% installments. Yes, that's an option you want to go for if you don't want to shell out all the money from your bank account. You can also rent different things versus buying. So for example, even air conditioning, water softener, furnace, you can rent those as well. The fourth thing that you can do is you can borrow more money if you don't have cash at all using HELOC. HELOC is the loan that you can get it from the same lender who gave you the mortgage at a decent rate. You can use that money for anything related to house, upgrades, repair, fixing, anything.
Regardless what stage you are in your home buying process, just go little by little and you don't have to spend right away. Of course, house is just like a baby or a brand new wife who need maintenance as well over the time. But take your time, make them happy as you feel comfortable.
We'll see you soon guys, next Saturday with another awesome video.
And don't forget, in between, we are always reachable to you. You can book an appointment through Facebook and have us live talk to you.
Till then, keep smiling, stay healthy wherever you are.
Guys, now I'm taking you to the mangrove. So anytime when Deepak needs a timeout, he comes to his... Guys, now I'm taking to the mangrove. 1, 2, 3, start.